Alrighty, what's happening? This is Lightning Bolt Forever back again with more Star Wars Jedi Knight 2 Jedi Outcast, Level 8 Nar Shaddaa Streets. So, our main objective for this level is to track down the gangster Reelo Baruk. And, we are on Nar Shaddaa. Yes, we are exploring the Vertical City once again. This was the very first planet we explored in our Dark Forces 2 adventure, so yeah. So this level, I'm starting off here.
I don't want to start any trouble.
Yeah, you want to lay low.
Better try not to attract too much attention.
Yeah, you want to lay low as much as possible, starting off here, because, we got all these thugs wandering around here, and they can be pretty dangerous if we, get too suspicious. Now, there are parts of this level that I absolutely love, and there are parts of this level that I absolutely hate. For one thing, I love the design, though. I mean, you can definitely tell... This is another one of those levels where you can tell a lot of thought was put into it, with all the ships flying around and all the hustle and bustle of the city. However, one of the things I hate the most about this level is guys like that way up there, the enemy placement. This level... Oh my gosh, the enemies in this level are so incredibly difficult to deal with, but you'll see more of that later. For right now, let's head into the cantina right here.
Basta Moruya.
Sure, no problem.
Jope Pola! Alright, so yeah, we have to hand over our weapons to these guys here. However, luckily for us, we get to keep the most important one. Haha. Anyway.
How's it going? Sorry.
Yeah, you can just go around and talk to the guys that are hanging out here.
Okay.
Yeah. So yeah, there's all these thugs just hanging out here. We have Rodians, we have Grands, we have Weakways.
Can I join you? Sorry.
Fine.
Can I join you?
No answer. Anyway. Yeah, back here.
Sorry.
You're not allowed backstage. And yeah, over here, look at this. Really? Mine crab fights? Really, guys? Come on. Wow. Anyway. Yeah, in this, I should point out, in this back office right here, you can grab some, armor if you need it. But, yeah, there's all these guys here. Not much to do. We can't really go anywhere else. Let's get a drink.
Bartender. Bartender.
Ah, Jedis. I had no ideas. What can I do for you, honored Jedis?
I'm no Jedi. I'm just a guy with a lightsaber and a few questions.
Of course. Many peoples have them.
Lightsabers?
Questions. How about a ruby bleels?
Corellian ale and a clean glass.
Of course, sirs. Now, you seek informations?
What do you know about Reelo Baruk?
A respected waste disposal manager. This very establishment contracts with him to remove our garbages.
Where does he take your garbages?
Who cares? Out of sight, out of minds, says us.
And it's all strictly legit, right?
As legitimate as anything on Nar Shaddaa, Mr. Just the Guy.
Do you know where I can find Baruk?
Trulies?
Trulies.
Wait here. I get them for you.
Never trust a bartender with bad grammar.
Damn. Alright, so the first thing we're going to do as soon as that is over with is activate Force Speed and start taking out all these guys here, because, we got a lot of guys to deal with here. And, it is possible to... Whoa, crap. It is possible to get through this completely unharmed, believe it or not. However, you do have to get really lucky with enemy placement. You can actually make it... Whoa. You can actually make it out of here with 100% health and armor. But very rarely does that happen, though, just because of how the enemies are all lined up and everything. But yeah, we eliminated all the bar scum, so now that we've taken care of that, let's get a couple secrets. So the first one is behind this wall here. You can push in either table. Doesn't really matter. You don't even have to force push it in. Just push it in, you can grab some health and shields. Let's see, what does this guy have to say? Please don't deactivate me. I'm just a droid. Anyway, we can head up around here, get the jump on this guy, and we can pick up his weapon, which we must have already picked it up. We can pick up the Tenlos DXR-6 Disruptor Rifle, which basically is basically just a super awesome, totally badass sniper rifle that literally lets you vaporize enemies. But more on that in just a second here. We're going to jump up here and grab our weapons that were confiscated from us, like our briar pistol. Hit this switch to open up the open the bar back up so we can interrogate the bartender. But if we head downstairs, we will come across I don't know what this thing is. I'm assuming looks like a refrigeration unit type thing. But anyway, force push it back and you get a secret with back to tanks and power cells. And I'm going to pick up the shields that are over here. Just because they're here and it'll top us off to 100%. Just like that. Alright. So let's interrogate this guy.
Alright, enough fooling around. Where's Reelo?
Please, noble Jedis! Not in the faces! Reelo's office is on higher levels. Follow the garbage collectors.
Noble Jedis! Alright, so anyway, let's get out our new weapon here, our Tenlos here. And we're going to have a... Yes, a Rodian with a sniper rifle up there. Basically, you know, this same disruptor rifle. And, those guys get to be common enemies in this level. But anyway, yeah, we took care of him. So, yes, we actually need to go out this way where we got our second secret. And out through this door. That was interesting there. He didn't even push down. But anyway, yeah, we head outside and, yes, we have escaped the bar alive. But now we need to find the entrance to Reelo's hideout. So, let's jump up here, and jump up here, and here's what I mean by vaporize. So yeah, you saw me use it on the one Rodian inside the cantina, but watch this. You can the secondary fire for this thing is the scope. You can zoom in, wind up a shot, and yeah, just totally just demolish these guys. I mean, they really don't stand a chance against this thing, if you have good aim and you use it well. Anyway, yeah, we're going to need to be... Dude, what the hell, man? You're not supposed to be able to see me from there. Yes, you can. Let's see. Zoom in right here. Get rid of him. And move very, very carefully. Yeah, if you try to move with the scope, it'll go back to just your regular view there. And that is because you can only move... You can only keep the scope on and move around while you're crouching. So yeah, we're going to have another... Sniper Rodian way up there. And yeah, the thing that I hate about these guys is that not only do I hate their placement, but not only do I hate their placement, but they are so incredibly accurate. And, I mean, if you have low enough health, they can kill you in one hit. It's actually pretty disgusting. So let's, we'll head to the upper level here. We're going to have some ammo back here. This thing uses power cells. I'll just pull that to myself there. And we'll get out the saber. And we're going to have a Rodian come around the corner. See ya! And if you look down there, there's a weak way down there. I'm going to charge up a shot here. And wait till he goes around this corner. That way we have a better chance of hitting him, just like that. Oh, and blow up that detonation pack there. So let's go ahead and collect that and get out the lightsaber. And quickly head around this side. Push this guy down, hack him open like that. And be careful, up there, way up there on that bridge, is a Rodian. And he's got a sniper rifle. Pretty much all the Rodians in this level do. But yeah, you want to take him out. Yeah, we're going to be switching a lot between the disruptor rifle and the lightsaber here. So, whoa! Holy crap, that was a weird series of events there. Anyway, yeah, get rid of both weak ways here. Ooh, nice, we hacked off his arm. Get rid of both the weak ways, and we're going to have some Grands up above. I like to use the crossbow on them. Yeah, the Grands, they're probably the second most dangerous enemy in this level because they throw thermal detonators at you. Anyway, let's head to the right. Back straight up. Whoa! And yeah, you can actually, yeah, you can actually push thermal detonators away from you, force push them. But let's see, real quick, let's head around here, push that box, send that guy flying over the edge. And we'll save those back to tanks. Let's go through this door here, saber throw on that guy. And now, okay, he's not there yet. There is going to be a guy up over there. As soon as we run back in here, he's going to show up. There he is. See ya! Anyway, that actually went pretty well. So let's, yeah, I'll still save those. So, let's, yes, we have to leap across right here. And make sure you take cover fast, because there's going to be... There he is. I was about to say, where is he? Yeah, there's going to be another one way up there. Another Rodian. Ooh, nice! Went right through the glass. But anyway, yeah. Get rid of the weak way, and there's going to be a Gran up here. We can just pull him, hack him open with our saber like that. Let's see. Oh, before I forget, there's also a Rodian way down there. And this guy... It's common for this guy, if you're new to this level, this guy may start shooting at you, and you may think, like, where the hell is an enemy shooting me from? Well, yeah, he's way down there. Anyway, let's break out some thermal detonators here, because I feel like using them right here. So right about there. Sweet! Alright, and we'll go ahead and use that back to tank there. Jump over these boxes. We have battery. And, yeah, shield booster. Yes, we can just head right on back up the way we came. We will not take that elevator. Instead, we are going to hop down here. And what we need to do is get... we need to jump down there into that room there. So let's just carefully... Yeah, you might... as you just saw, it is possible to get down here without taking damage. And yeah, you need to jump in through this way because you need to hit the switch to open the door. And so that you can just progress altogether. But, ooh, hello. But, yeah. Get rid of him, go through here, but yeah. It is possible to, not get hurt there. Anyway, yeah, in here we have power cells, and we have a box that we can use the force on, so if we pull it, it'll actually, trigger this elevator to lower, because it lands on a pressure platform. And to go back up, you just push the box. So, let's see, get rid of him. And right here, we're gonna have quite a few enemies to snipe here. Carefully inch your way over, but don't go out past this wall. What you want to do is zoom in on that that glass walkway over there, because we're going to have a weak way coming from that direction, and we want to take him out as fast as possible before we even dream of heading up to that area. So he should be making his way out here momentarily. There he is, and that's the end of him. All right, yeah, just shoot out the floor. So, over this way we got two... Sniper Rodians, and as you can see, there's one right there. But yeah, the thing about these guys... Ooh, nice, vaporized him. Freaking hell, man. The thing about these guys is that they can see you from places you wouldn't even know existed. Because, see, they're so accurate. And did I get him? Yeah, I got him. And yeah, they can manage to hit you, like, even behind corners, too. That's what's so dangerous about them. But yeah, lower that on down, and when you do that, this guy will spawn. So we'll just get him in the leg like that. Head on up, and to the right, and quickly duck, or crouch, whatever you need to do, by this bridge here. And I guess you didn't really vaporize him, but make sure you get him, and don't walk too far up over the ramp there, because you need to be able to get him, and at the same time, make sure that he doesn't get you. So, what? Die! There we go. Yeah. Anyway, let's hack through here. That could have gone a lot smoother. Whoa, what are you doing? Kyle, what are you doing? There, die. Sheesh, I don't know what happened there, but Kyle decided to do some crazy ninja spin move there. Anyway, yeah, we got... couple Rodians and a weak way over there. I like to snipe them off, or at least pick them off with the crossbow there. This door does not open. This door does not open, but this one does. And we can lower this elevator down. I'm just going to go ahead and use one of those. And through this door, we have a Gran. So we'll get rid of him like that. And we have a Rodian. Sweet. And way over there, shoot this Gran. But unfortunately, the bridge blows up. So, yes, obviously, as you may have already expected, we're going to have to be able to get to the other side there. So, whoop. Oh, just die. Alright, that's the end of him. Now, yes. Secret number 3. Yes, this is how you get it. You need to jump over to the other side, and yeah, watch out for ships passing by, but oh, it's a very precarious jump to make. It can be pretty tricky, and you almost have to be pixel perfect for it to work, otherwise you will die. And that's not the only nerve-wracking jump we're going to have to make in order to get a secret. Kyle, can you get up here, please? Thank you. Let's grab all this stuff here. Now, instead of just going back the way we came, taking the long way back, we're just going to drop down. Because I'd rather just do it this way than, I'd rather just do it this way than, friggin', what you call it? Jump over that bridge again. But anyway, yeah, carefully drop down here, and this is how we get secret number 4. So, carefully. You just want to inch your way down. There we go. And like this, and like this. And you can grab both of these back to tanks, grab some shields, grab some ammo if you need it. And yeah, now, yes, now comes the part where, yeah, we pretty much have to go back the way we came. So yeah, a little bit of backtracking involved in this level, but not much. It's not that long of a way back. And while I'm thinking about it, when this game came out, there were a lot of questions as to why Kyle's lightsaber was a different color between Mysteries of the Sith and this game. Well, at some point, at some point, after Kyle nearly fell to the dark side in Mysteries of the Sith, in Mysteries of the Sith, he kept using Yun's lightsaber that he got from Dark Forces 2. But at some point after that game and before this game, he constructed his very own, and that's the one that we've got now. But he decided to give up his ways of the Force after nearly falling to the dark side at the end of Mysteries of the Sith. But, yeah, that's why it's a different color. He pretty much made his own instead of just deciding to keep using Yun's old saber. But anyway, yeah, we're back in here now. Sorry about that, I had to cough. Anyway, yeah, we want to jump through this window now. And over this way, we have this little, speeder here that we need to jump on. When it gets close enough, yeah, just like that. That can be very nerve-wracking to do. As well as this jump here. Yeah, there we go. Because it's constantly moving around. But anyway, let's, get on this elevator here, go through this door. Now you can see right there is a little detonation pack. Well, yeah, you want to shoot that before you go over there because it's going to blow up and hurt you. But anyway, yeah, carefully pass by on the right side. And right here, we have... Okay. Yeah, we have... well, yeah, obviously if we jump into the water, we're going to get electrocuted. So what we need to do is just blow open this wall here and shoot that pipe there. And that is going to make it safe for us to go, get into the water. We can force pull the bridge, jump up here, get this unsuspecting weak way, and, once you get up here, yeah, there's no way, that door doesn't open down there. But yeah, if you head across the way here, there's a secret over there, as you can see with the back to tank and the shield booster. However, it's very tricky to get to. And what I'm actually going to do is something that I very rarely do in my Let's Plays. I'm actually going to save right here and edit out my failed attempts at getting across to the other side there. Because this is a very difficult jump to make, and I probably won't get this on the first try, so I'm just going to cut to my successful attempt of it. Alright, jump! Oh, there we go. Alright, whew! Okay, there's secret number 5. And to get back, I can always get across, but never get back. Jump! Okay, woo! There we go, okay. Made it! Alright, sweet. I think a little thing with that, that I just kind of found that out in my failed attempts, is that if you angle the camera facing down above Kyle's head, you can at least get a better... You can at least get a better view of where you're jumping, and that was really scary. Anyway, let's, excuse me, buddy. I'm gonna hit this switch and jump down here.
Those look like garbage haulers to me. They must end up at Reelo's.
Yeah, this is how we're gonna get into Reelo's hideout here. So yes, force pull this little platform over, jump over here, and what I basically did with the last secret is what I'm gonna do here. As you can see, that little compartment is open right there. That's where the sixth and final secret of the level is. So once again, I'm going to save and just cut to my successful attempt at getting that secret. Alright, so what you have to do for this secret is basically jump and... Whoa, I got in! Wow, that was only my second try. I thought that was going to take me a lot longer. But yeah, what you need to do... And yes, here's the final secret. What you need to do is basically jump...
I wonder if there's an override to change the route.
Yeah, what you basically need to do is jump and crouch to get in here. So let's hack this open. And carefully, let's make our way down here. This is going to take us to... we can cut open the grate there. This is basically going to take us to pretty much where we just were, so we don't need to go back through there. But yeah, Kyle mentioned something about changing the route, and he is referring to the route of those garbage haulers that, that garbage hauler that we just rode, because... Yeah. It's not going to go the way we want, so let's drop down here. Yeah, this is how you get back. What you need to do is use the force on these switches here, because what's going to happen is the garbage haulers, instead of going forward into Reelo's hideout, we're just going to go into those side compartments there. But anyway, that is how that's how you finish the level. And pretty soon this is going to open up here. And into Reelo's hideout we go. Alrighty, and with that, we have found the entrance to Reelo Baruk's hideout. So, with this level now, finally done, and with minimal speed bumps, we can now safely proceed into level 9, Nar Shaddaa hideout. So until then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I'll catch you later.